In this video, we'll be doing 5 integrals that require both use substitution and also integration by parts. So it's going to be fun. Have a look. For the first one, we have the integral of parentheses with ln x and then raised to the second power. First thing first, do not bring the 2 to the front. This means ln x times ln x. This is not the same as ln of x squared, which means ln of x times x. If this is the question, yes, we can bring the 2 to the front and that will make the question study easier, but not this right here. So what do we do? Yes, use substitution first. Perhaps we'll let u equal the inside first and see what happens. And we can differentiate this right now and say du is equal to 1 over x dx. That's fine. But if you do it this way, it's easier. When we have u is equal to ln x, this right here is the same as saying x is equal to e to the u, the inverse function. And then we can look at this and differentiate and say dx is equal to e to the u du. It's slightly easier this way. And now take this integral to the u world. Ln x is the u, raise that to the second power, and dx is e to the u du. And do we recognize that? Yeah, right? Of course, we do the integration by parts now, and of course, we'll use the DI format. So let's go ahead and put that down right here. D and also the I plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. This is the fun one. We will be differentiating u squared and then integrating e to the u. Do it once, do it twice, do it 3 times. Okay, we didn't need a last one. Let's just erase it because we see a 0 right here already. And integrating e to the u, man, we can do that all day long. So now, we pretty much have the answer already. This times this, this times this, and this times that. And we know that u is equal to ln x, so we'll just plug that in along the way. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, first we'll have u squared, which is ln x squared. I'll write it down like this, ln x, and then square, times e to the u, which is just x. Continue, we have the minus 2, and then the u is ln x, I'll put that down right here, and then multiply by e to the u, which is x. Lastly, this times that, which is plus 2, and e to the u is x. That's it. And of course, put on the plus c here, that will do it. That's the answer for that. Now for the second question, it looks really scary, right? We have to integrate e to the square root of x. But don't worry, this is doable, and we just have to first do a u sub. So let's go ahead and let u equal square root of x. And here, let's isolate the x first before we take the derivative. Square both sides, we know x is going to be u squared, and then differentiate now, we get 2u du. Now take this integral to the u world, we see this is the integral e to the u, and then dx is that which is the 2u du. And that's pretty much it. And again, we will just do like what we did for the first question. And perhaps we like to write this down first. So I'll say this is the integral of 2u e to the u du. And now let's just integrate this real quick. Let's put it down on the side d and also the I plus minus plus. That should be enough. Here, I will be differentiating 2u. So 2u here. And then integrating e to the u. Do it once, do it twice, done. Again, here, e to the u, e to the u. Perfect. So ladies and gentlemen, what do we have here? First, this times that, u is square root of x. So we will have 2 square root of x. And then e to the u, which is again square root of x. So you have e to the square root of x right here. And then this times that. So we have minus 2 e to the u, which is the square root of x. And then we are done. Put the plus c. Yep, this is slightly easier. This is definitely easier than the first question. I should have made this the first question. But anyway, that's it. Okay, for number 3, we'll be integrating cosine of ln x. And it looks really scary because we have ln x inside of cosine. But it's actually not so bad because if we let u equal the inside, and then just put this integral to the u world and see what happens. That would be the idea. So let's see. This right here means x is equal to e to the u, and then differentiate both sides. We have this. Alright, now take this to the u world. We have integral, cosine, and this is u inside. And the dx is that, which is e to the u du. And perhaps, this is why I personally preferred it, we put the e before cosine sign. Yeah. So e to the u, and then cosine u du. This right here, again, requires integration by parts. And it is the repeating case. So I'm going to do it on the side and make sure we have enough space to finish all the work. So let's see, d and also the I, plus, minus, plus. We will be differentiating e to the x, or e to the u in this case actually, and then integrating cosine u. If you switch this, doesn't matter, you will end up with the same answer. All right, once, twice, just e to the u. Here, integrating cosine u, we first get positive sine u, and then do this again, we get negative cosine u. And this is where we stop, because we see the e to the u and also cosine u. The function part repeats from the original, so we stop. And if it's a repeated situation, we are just going to copy down the same integral again right here, which is integral e to the u cosine u. This is going to give us this part first, which is positive e to the u sine u, and then again positive e to the u cosine u, and lastly we will have to multiply these two things and put that inside of an integral. Positive times negative though, so it will be a minus integral, and then we have e to the u cosine u du. Alright, and now have a look. This integral and that integral are the same, but we will just combine them together. So we will just add this integral right here on both sides, namely e to the u cosine u du, and then we will also put that down over there. This is not so bad to do, of course, if you want to do that in your head, that's totally okay. Feel welcome to do so. But yeah, just wanted to make it super clear for you guys. So, one integral plus another integral, we have two integrals. So this right here is 2 integral e to the u cosine u du, which is all that. So e to the u sine u. And then plus e to the u cosine u. And lastly, we don't want the 2, so let's multiply everybody by 1/2. So as you can see, this is going to be that, and we're pretty much done. So perhaps we'll just go back and we'll also put a u whatever x back here. We'll take the answer back to the x world, right? So first we have 1/2. So let me write that down. Next we have e to the u, which is going to be just the x. So perhaps I'll put that down in red. No, that's e to the u, it's just x. Next, we have sine u, u is lnx, so we'll just write it as sine of lnx. Next, plus 1/2, and then e to the u against x, and then lastly, we have the cosine u, which is cosine lnx. Yep, that's it, that will do it. So let's go ahead and put down the plus c, and that's it. For number 4, we'll be integrating x times inverse tangent of x squared. So we'll do a u sub first. Let u equal the inside, which is x squared, and then differentiate both sides right away. Because this one is actually not so bad. This x and that x will cancel out. Let's isolate the dx first though. So dx is equal to du over 2x. Alright, take this integral to the u world. Here is the integral, x times inverse tangent. This is the u. And then dx is du over 2x. Good. Now, cancel this out. And we have the 1/2 factor, so we'll put that on the outside of the integral. So here we have 1/2 integral, and then this is inverse tangent of u in the u world, which we have done it before already, but let's just do it again. I'll do that for you guys right here. So, integration by parts. Let me just put down the d and also the I right here. Plus, minus, we will be differentiating inverse tangent of u. and integrating 1. Do this, we get 1 over 1 plus u squared. Do that, in the u world, we get u. So that's pretty much it. Well, I'm going to just focus on this right now, so let me just finish the integral right here. The first part is going to be this times that, which is u times inverse tangent of u. And then we are going to multiply these two things together from this row and put that inside of an integral. So that's a minus integral, this over that, which is u over 1 plus u squared du. And right here, we have to do another substitution, but I'm really going to leave that to you guys right here. Let w equal the denominator, and then you will see dw is 2u du. That's just pretty much the same thing. So you should be comfortable doing the u sub now, so go ahead and do that. But here we have the u inverse tangent of u, and then minus this right here will be, let me just tell you the answer is 1/2. Ln of the bottom, which is 1 plus u squared, but this is always positive, so we just need a parenthesis. So that will be the integral of inverse tangent of u. Now I'm going to just put that back here, and don't forget we still have the 1/2 that we will have to multiply, and then we also have to bring the x squared back to the u. So a few things that we are doing at this step. So first, we have the 1/2 times this. U is x squared. So we have x squared and then inverse tangent of u, which is x squared. So that's the first part. And then 1/2 times negative 1/2, which is going to give us negative 1 over 4, and then the rest, ln 1 plus x squared is for the u, and you square that, which is going to be x to the fourth power. So I'll put that down, x to the fourth power like this. Yep, just like that, and then we are done. So put down the plus c, this right here is it. For number 5, we have the integral of x to the fifth power times sine of x to the third power. So let's do it yourself first. Let u equal the inside, which we have the x to the third power, and then do the usual business. We have du is equal to 3x squared dx, and divide this on both sides. We are looking at dx is equal to du over 3x squared. And now let's take this integral to the u world. We have the integral x to the fifth power, and then sine x to the third power is our u. And then dx is that, so let's write that down right here. And this right here is actually really nice because we can cancel, and now we will have x to the third power. And what's the x to the third power? That's exactly our u. So you can see that this is the integral. And for this time, they need to write the 1/3 right here. And you'll see why. So we have 1/3, and x to the third power is the u, and then we have the rest, which is sine u and then du. So right here, we can just do integration by parts. And of course, let's write that down right here. So put down the d and also the I, plus, minus, plus. And I can just take this right here to be differentiated. So we have the 1/3 u, and let's go ahead and integrate sine u. All right, differentiating this one time, we get 1/3. And do it again, we get 0. So we stop. And then for integrating sine u, we first get negative cosine u, and do it again, we get negative sine u. So we are ready to go to have our final answer. This times this, we have negative, so we have negative 1/3. U is x to the third power, so we can just write that down. And also, we have the cosine of u, which is x to the third power. Next, we multiply this and that, so it will be positive, and then we have 1/3 sine u, which is just sine of x to the third power. And we're all done after we put down the plus c. This right here is it. All right, so hopefully this video helps. If you guys need more help with calculus, you guys can check out my other videos, and you guys can also subscribe to the channel for future videos. And as always, that's it.